So without further ado, let's jump in and continue our playthrough. So, like I said before though, I kind of feel possibly a little bit advantaged by this because I've seen this level run quite a lot in Death Unites as speedruns, so yeah, we can only hope things will go relatively swell for us. That's not a good start though, Nock, let's be honest. That is though, that was good. Alright. Ooh, nearly. Okay. This is dash too early. I didn't quite have my input right there. I need to go upwards right. They dash down. I need to just dash across. Dashed up slightly too early. And again. Is that one of my moderators I see in the chat? There we go. Oh, jeez. What's going on, Beatmaster? Hope you're well, my man. How you doing? Can I dash and jump at the same time? You lurk away, buddy. You lurk away. Just got back from Canada. Nice. One place I was meant to go when I was younger, but the trip got cancelled and we ended up going to Switzerland instead. Not that that's a bad place. Quite enjoyed Switzerland. How am I meant to... Ah, okay. So I hit myself and then probably jump off the block. If I can. Probably easier said than done. Did you climb Mount Celeste while you was there, given that it's in Canada? I just don't know how I'm meant to, in a way. Skiing trip, nice. Sounds like I had some fun. How am I meant to do this? Like that, maybe. There we go. Alright. Two keys. Okay, that's... I like spike jumping up there, that's for sure. Let's go do this first. Go all the way down. Grab that. Okay. Almost there. Stamina. It's never good. I gotta try and not do so much movement, I think, when I'm grabbing onto this. Maybe I should go back to what I was trying before. I'm seem to be having more trouble trying to do it this way than I was trying to do it like from bottom first, but it's better. That's not. Need to grab that. I need to grab. Don't know why I like bounced off that though. To dash up here, dash across. I need to stop dying. That might be a good start, but I need to go up this side. No. I moved too much when I was grabbing the ledge. Again. That's interesting. that would work pretty well, actually, if I could just... if I've run out of stamina. Alright. We keep learning. There at all. I think grab onto the ledge. I did a bit of a panic dash there. Maybe I should focus on getting this one first. Cross to that one, then back across. Okay. Alright, I need to focus down. I'm not getting... my controls are all... did it. Hallelujah. Alright, so... inputs right. Almost. Fractionally too early. all it was. By a fraction. Coming out there too early. I need to leave it longer. Dash up and try and hit the block. I had it there, I think. But I think I need to use some, if I can, use some upward momentum skills. There we go. See, that's the part of the speedrun that they actually skip, because they do a they do like a key skip, and then on the run they actually jump up through. Oh, this bit's horrible. Like do a straight up jump, but I need to be like pixel perfect. I need to hold direction. There we go. Hesitated. Thank you. I swear down, my controller is trolling me. Thank you. Pretty much go straight away, or else the cycles don't work. Oh my god! How on earth did I cheese that? Oh. So, in the speed run, in the speed run, they jump across those spikes. I'm not that good yet, so I gotta work out now how to get this other freaking key to get round Z spikes. Maybe. I have no idea how I would do a hyper dash kind of thing all the way across there. Well, I guess I gotta do this room then. Jump across and then jump off. Like that, there we go. To hit off that one. Ooh. Alright, so I need to go do this again, right? Oh yeah, sorry. Alright, so this is just about pure speed at this point. Grab it. There we go. See, again, I don't know how to do this, because in the... Oh. Is that bubble always there? What? It's not even a checkpoint. Well, this first bit's not too difficult, at least. Says. He says. I know I shouldn't have saved, right? Terrible. I feel like the more I hesitate, though, the harder it is. I should have just gone for it. I'm good, thanks, Aaron. How are you? Day been, my man. Oh, and I thought you maybe had, because I saw Irk posting a lot of stuff about DA earlier on. hit. So maybe I should grab. Maybe I should grab the wall instead of trying to do this all in one go. I know, it's great. It fascinates me every time, Beamaster. Like, you struggle on something and then you just breeze past it until you get to the next one. I'll change that out a bit more simple now. On your map, you mean, Errand? Yeah, boys. Please say this is the end. Please give me... Wow. This room is punishing. Jump too early off that crumbling block. Yes, it does. So you can see the whole layout of the map level. I've lost the cycle now. The thing about a lot of these rooms though is once you've played them a few times, you learn the cycle. That kind of also makes it a bit easier. There we go. Do you have any joy getting any luck getting hold of Harry? Or are you still trying, Errand? Time for a bit of free falling. Start. I think going the other way, it doesn't matter, it's a symmetrical room, so. Why did I think that was a ledge I could stand on? That's crazy. I do like symmetry, yes. What I don't like is losing my dash. Come on. I'm a sucker for symmetry. You know, like when I'm doing, like, trying to make a portal map, I always try and make it as symmetrical as I can. Can't seem to hit that little gap. Which you thought it'd be pretty easy to hit the gap once I've hit the button, because you thought I'd be like in the right position from hitting the button. Alright, thanks for hanging around, everybody. I will catch up with you probably Thursday. I'm overcompensating. No, but I'm not around tomorrow because not around tomorrow, because I'm going to London again tomorrow, so I'll probably catch up with you Thursday. Cheers, buddy. Catch you later. Alright, now onto this, and this is going to be an absolute pain in the ass. I really struggled with these things in the normal A side. These things were like just awful. Grab the wall, please, Madeline. Many thanks, much obliged. The only way I can see to do it is try and lure the thing over there. Nope, that's how we do it. It's probably not how we do it, but I'll do the room all in one go though. That's unfortunate. Yeah, that's better. That was much better. Apart from the fact I got bullied by the fish. I don't know why Madeline, like, just stops grabbing walls every now and then. Are you for real? Oh no! No! I hit. Alright, so I caught the freaking fish's sonic wave thing as they regenerate and it gives you a boost. Damn it! I don't think I could have done that again. I don't think I could probably do that again if I tried. I think my problem is with the switch, I'm holding grab when I get near it. There we go. We're getting there. There we go. I'd hardly say nailed it, but... bop him on the head as he, you know, dashed back. So that stopped me from then dashing onto the next platform, which was a little bit frustrating. Same again. How did I get my dash back when I didn't land on his head? It seems like there's like a little area on them then that I can actually, I can get a boost off them where I don't actually have to disintegrate them, I guess. Too quick. I had Smeltry Republic. What's going on, my man? It's been a while. Cheese that, don't know how. Alright. This is the bit I wasn't looking forward to. Because I really struggle to deal with Contribution of many deaths will make this piece of art shine. There must be like a really... No, it's not, because the door shuts right as soon as you... As soon as you leave. Unfortunately, that would be fantastic if I could iron smeltery, I agree, but... Yeah, that ain't happening, unfortunately. Unfortunately, there are some... I have to take it with me. I have to take the crystal with me. I don't get a choice about that, unfortunately. Now, I'm not very good at it, but there are... You can actually get a lot better movement here with the crystal by dashing, releasing it and dashing, but I'm just really not very good at doing that. Oh, you. And plus, you see that like white bit of light that is like above the door? That actually stops the creature from going past that point, so... Oh my goodness. And of course, there's no freaking halfway checkpoint, is there? That's a better strat. That was a much better strat for dealing with the crystal and everything. Just didn't hit the button. If I'd have just thrown Theo there, I would have done it. See, that's like the... That's the advanced movement. I just pulled it off by, like, chance there. Totally cheesed that, but... No! This is the tough bit now. We've mastered this first bit. I'd say we mastered it, but... still wall jump. Well, that makes things lots easier, doesn't it? Jeez. Oh, jeez. I didn't realize I could still wall kick jump. How did I not? Well, that wasn't too painful. Kind of wasn't expecting that. It was kind of weird. All right, last room. Sure, this is the last room. Stop dashing. stop dashing. Now, I do know, contrary to popular belief, I do know this B-side because it's part of the, it's in the actual routing of the speedrun. So I have seen it a couple of times, I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure that this is the last room. Well, we get the Crystal Heart anyway. Crystal Heart is the final room, but I don't know if, yeah. Yeah, all right, so this is the final room. This is where we get the... I assume he's talking about Death Wish, right? Throwing Theo slightly too early. Because video game logic. No, obviously you haven't seen the A-sides, but on the normal levels, basically, the guy is, my friend is stuck inside the crystal, so that's why I die if the crystal dies, because effectively my friend dies, so. We did it, boys and girls. Temple B-side done. Thank God for that. Rare moment of rage. Is that the Witness video? Was that the Witness rage? Next up, reflection. I'm gonna take a quick bathroom break. I'll be right back. All right, we're back. Yeah, the Witness, man. That's some serious rage on that freaking puzzle, man. That puzzle was just insane. Oh my goodness. Thank you. All right, we did it. I know, right? This bit, the feathers, they're a really cool mechanic, but they make it so difficult because throughout the entire rest of the game, you use the D-pad. That's the one part of the game you can't use the D-pad for. You have to use the analog stick, and changing from a D-pad to analog stick is just crazy. I can't tell you how weird it feels. Talking about controller? No, PS4. Talking about the actual what I'm actually playing on. I'm playing on PC. Horrible spiky bits on this level. Not to mention, there is a boss fight as well at the end of this level. Which actually I was pleasantly surprised about when I played the A side. I thought the boss fight was going to be pretty solid, and it was one of the parts of the game I really enjoyed. It wasn't too difficult. Just a feather. It's for this exact reason. You see the struggles here? This is why I'm not 114% in this game. Close. Basically, to 114% of the game, after you've 100%ed it, you have to get 25 golden strawberries. And to get a golden strawberry, you have to complete a level without dying. Every single level in the game without dying. And it's not something I'm going to be doing on stream, at least. Because we'd be here for freaking years. Nice. Dashing too early. Do you have like a similar thing to the US in Canada where it's like, I think you can, can't you like learn, get your driver's license at 16 in the States? I'm really quite ill-educated on things that happen in the States, laws and stuff. So the only thing you can get in UK it's at like sort of 16. I think it's 16. Can you drive at 16 in the States? I think you can. I know you're in Canada. That's why I said it was you the same as the States. in the UK, you can get a provisional at 16, but you can only drive like a. Yes, you beast. Got you. You can only drive a. Ride a moped on provisional license on like a learner plates. So I gotta work my way around on the bumpers to get the feather, then to go all the way up there. Oh joy. I need to get my dash back after hitting a bumper, so. That's one good thing. We get to play pinball because pinball is excellent. But what's frustrating is I gotta do all this, again, I gotta do all this with the D-pad, and then at the last minute when I grab that feather, I gotta switch to analog. It's so, it makes it like so much more complex. And I've got to pick my way through the gap as well, of course. At least I get the dash back though, so I can actually, if I can hold it on the bumper, I can actually kind of just try and position myself a little bit better. Good call. Cheers, Ice Meltry. Hopefully that'll say reflection in a minute. Let's just go backwards and forwards on the bumpers. It's a magical time. I don't know why it's magical. That's a wrong word. Wrong choice of words. Thing is, if you don't hit the bumper correctly, it throws you off at such a weird angle. And it's really hard to bring it back. Of course. Long word. Where's the long word thing come from? I'm not following Lance Miltry. Which is anything about long words? Did I say something about long words? See, look. Nobody believes me. I have a terrible memory. This is how bad my short-term memory is. Did it again. Hey mom, I did that thing again. Oh, we're going to be here for the long haul on this one. I can see it now. Alright, that's what I want to do. The thing is, I can't practice the feather until I get up there. Astroneer. What's a space game, I guess? No, I haven't. Clearly, from my reaction to, is that a space game? Should probably tell you everything I know about that game. I live in a bubble, Iron Smeltery, literally. I very rarely check the news. How amazing is amazing? Can I actually, if I hit that, I dash up, I could probably hit that, but I need to be dashing onto the right hand side, so I need to refine my path with the feather, I think, to actually get on the right place. Also need to find my proper route through here. Scale 1290? What? You've lost me again. You've lost me again. Oh, you're talking about Astroneer. Yeah, I realised what you're talking about afterwards. I realised. Well, I've subconsciously realised I do a lot. After I've died, I kind of like take my hand off my controller and like rub my nose or rub my forehead or something. It's weird. I don't realise I'm doing it, but I do it. Well, I do realise I'm doing it, but I just can't help myself from doing it. I'll stop that conversation there. It's the wrong way, high smeltering. Because honestly, I appreciate the chat. But what did you come in here to lurk? Too tight through that section there. So if I can refine the angle a little bit, then we'll be good. It's all good. Like I say, I appreciate it. I don't feel like I feel like I have to take a tighter line through there though, because as the feather runs out, I don't have enough time. Oh my god, if I'd have... Yeah. Yeah, boy. Alright, let's have a quick look at this. Have a quick look. Open world survival. So is it like Minecraft in space or something? For lack of a like better understanding of the game. Are you kidding me? I see what you want me to do. This swapping from analog, like D-pad to analog stick, is so difficult. That's what happens when you try and do it with the D-pad. There's just no control at all. You need so much more, so many more degrees of movement for these feathers. Now you need to go round, jump on that side, jump to the other side, smash it again, then jump up, is what I think I need to do. Yeah, like that. Come on, muscle memory, do your thing. I'm using a PS4 controller, Jelly Girl. What's going on? Welcome to the stream. Hope you're well. I didn't even dash down there. That was terrible. I'm using D-pad for general movement, and then the feathers, I'm using analog sticks. Where I'm really struggling is when I get to like the feather bits, is swapping from the D-pad movement to the analog stick quickly and then back again if need be. That's where I kind of like feel like I'm struggling. I missed it. Sorry. Excuse me. I didn't even clear the top of the thing there. I have not, no. I'd imagine the keyboard's pretty hard though. Surely you can't get the... how would you get like the precision of movement with the feathers though, you're playing with the keyboard? Oh, okay. Getcha. Yeah, it just takes practice, I guess. But I just thought I've watched like a lot of the... don't want to do that. I don't have a dash. I watched a lot of TGH's runs and things. I think one of the ones I was watching him play at Games Done Quickly. And the developers were there, and they were talking about like the range. They were talking about the range of movement, and they said like there's you have to use the analog stick because something like 13. I think the D-pad only gives you something like a very limited. I can't remember exactly what they said, but yeah, they definitely said you had to use the analog stick. So I don't know. I don't know, I'm just blabbering, I apologise, I don't know what I'm thinking. I'm trying to talk about my struggle for controls here, and... I need to jump straight up. No worries, Ice. Thing is, at the moment, like with a lot of this game, it's just muscle memory kicks in. Once you've done it a few times and you start working it out, all right. So I got to do that there, then hit it. Okay. Yeah. Once the muscle memory starts kicking in, it's like it gets a lot easier. Oh, you doofus! Wow, I didn't expect to like get over the side of it, over the top of it. It kind of threw me off a little bit. Yeah, and then I kind of expect to do the same again and totally failed. That's a shame. Got it. Yes. Oh dear. I see bumpers. Find the screen shake disorientating on the bumpers. I gotta dash straight up. To the other side, try and get through to the other side, maybe. Dashing too early though, at the minute. Alright, yep, that's what I need to do. Yeah, the second bump hit that time was a bit lucky, if I'm honest. Ooh, grab onto there and jump down and across. Ooh, nearly. Out of curiosity, Jelly Girl, how far, how much completion did you go for the game? Did you, are you golden strawberries or 100%? Just out of curiosity. I'm hesitating on that bumper. Do all the seasides. Yeah, I've kind of decided I want to kind of try and do the golden strawberries, but it'll not be something I'm doing on stream, because we'll just be here for months and months and months trying to do golden strawberries and doing all the levels deathless. I've got a massive learning curve to get good enough for that. From what I've seen though, I'm led to believe that the seasides are generally easier than the B-sides because they're smaller. Yeah, I do want to do an 80% speedrun as well. I have been practicing Forsaken City. Which I can do in just, I think, a little over 2 minutes. But I don't really want to get too much into the speedrun until I've actually completed all through 100%. Alright, we're here. am I meant to do that? Ooh, maybe I use my dash to... I've also had a go at doing Forsaken City dashless. And I get to one point and I just get stuck. After the it's the second screen on like the middle section. I can't get over where you've got like you climb up the wall and then you've got some spikes and I just can't get past that, them spikes. It's I spent probably about an hour and a half trying to get that one screen done. I don't know if you've attempted that at all. I think what I need to do is I need to learn how to do the spike jump, but when the spikes are on the wall, not on like a floor, a vertical platform. Muscle memory's gone for this at the minute. I haven't tried. The first, like... Because, obviously, I think Forsaken City is broken into three parts. The first part's relatively simple. And then the first and second screen of the middle section are just ridiculous. There's not really a lot of useful. Well, there are useful guides. That's a unfair statement to say. Yeah. See how far you can get. But definitely to do that, you need to be quite good at doing spike jumps. Which, if you're going to be doing the 80% speedrun anyway, you're kind of going to want to learn spike jumps. To get past some areas. I didn't think I was going to get over there, actually. That's why I kind of was pressing the wrong direction. Oh, I hate these bumpers. And then when I do make it, I don't carry enough height across to the thing. Just can't win. Well, My muscle memory is like completely gone at this point. So close. We got this, Nock. Come on, we can do this. It's all about hitting that last bumper in the right angle. Come on, Nock. Come on. Man, this is didn't diagonal dash the right direction. I know what my error is, and I keep making the same mistake every time. Yes! We got through the room, boys and girls. Alright, so I think I've got to like swap directions. Using that. I almost cheesed that, jeez. Well, I'm complaining. There's a high prop there somehow. How's that dashless going, Jelly Girl? Where have you got up to? Tick-tock. Come on, game. Come on, IMG, you are... Ah, yes, right, so... that room is tough. But it's the next room. The next room where I have the biggest issue with. But... that room did take me quite a long time to also get through. I will be honest. There's like two rooms back to back and they are not easy rooms. I feel like I've brought great pain on you tonight by mentioning that dashless, so I do apologise, Jelly. Hope you can forgive me. Yeah, I'm not so hot with the movement tech and things, but the way to get past it . Alright. So the way to get past it if I can do this. So, the way I have learned to do it, it's still pretty hard, is jumping across here. So you've got to try and spike jump here. I don't know how you're trying to do it. I assume you're trying to do it this way, but... you've literally got to be... pixel perfect. Of course, I misread your comment as well, because I read that as you keep missing, as in you don't hit your hyper dashes, but of course you can't do a hyper dash or a wave dash because it's no dash. Sorry, my bad. I misinterpreted what you said. But yeah, that's basically bane of my existence. But then it's not so much this one. It's the... this one is the one that's the problem. So, you can get across to here quite comfortably. Get up to here, and then you got to kind of like jump, but then get a boost off the spike, and that's what I can't do. That's the one that I can't do, and don't know how to do. So from the videos, I can see like people get extra high from the spikes, and it just gives them enough momentum just to like carry them over and onto the platform, but... yeah, I have no idea. Anyway, back to the task at hand. Could have hit it there. I'm not getting a good connection onto this bumper. I need to wait till it goes low, and I think I need to diagonal up right jump that, because trying to do what I'm doing just isn't working. Dash through there. I don't know what I did there. I totally messed it up. got to dash. Oh, deep concentration mode's kicked in again. Dash up. Had no dash. These bumpers are the worst. I feel like I'm getting somewhere with this now though. Hallelujah!
Yeah.
Oh, I... totally messed that up. Too close to the top of this block. Let me go back a bit further first before I... Gotta love that noise that it makes. Dash though, do I? Man. I was all over the place there. That wasn't good. And there, I didn't get towards the... I wasn't at the top of the block. I wonder if I need the bumper. Yeah, I need the bumper. All right, well, I'm about done. So I think I'm going to leave it there for tonight. Thank you very much, everybody, for tuning in. Another one and a bit. B-sides down. Only three more to complete. Then we can move on to the C-sides. But yeah, thank you very much for watching. We'll be back on Saturday night with some more Celeste. Hopefully getting through Reflection at least and starting Summit. But until then, I've been Nock. You've been awesome. See ya.